According to Odrek Rawogo, the four-point export strategy will help more businesses start exporting and will help those already exporting to sell more products to more countries.
That we can rebuild the confidence of the private sector that our country can compete. Our country has some of the best brains in the world. When I was in South Africa, I met a group that has 43 surgeons from Uganda.
Speaking to journalists today at his office in Naguru, Rawogo, who also doubles as the chair of the Presidential Advisory Committee on Trade and Industrial Development, argued that reaching $6 billion of export by 2028 means more jobs and more opportunities for the Ugandan entrepreneurs.
Yes, we have more capacity than we've ever had, even when with corona effects, but we are not alert to the opportunities available to us. We are acting as if we don't have competition. So we want to rebuild that confidence and trust with the public and private sector that if we get this 6 billion new money, the lessons we learn by doing that will give us another 10 and another 10, and we will be strong.
He noted that the committee he heads is working hard to turn things around for the country's exports to grow.
45% of our imports came from Asia. 70% of that 45 came from China and India. It tells you something. There must be export funding they give to their companies. As long as they identify market, they bring their goods.
The strategies they are focusing on include to conduct thorough market research in foreign countries before Ugandan exporters send their goods there, to boost border infrastructure and at the airport as a way of positioning the country's exports, to ensure effective coordination among the government ministries in business, and to speed up the formulation of the export credit facility, which will offer exporters loans at a low interest rate.
I'm more concerned about coordination and organization and seeing the similar objectives on this question of exports. I can tell you, every country that has grown its exports and sent her companies abroad, that country becomes different. There's culture change, there's technology change, there are new value chains companies get into, there's change in how you keep time.
Relatedly, a team of business experts from South Korea and United Arab Emirates are set to meet the president from the 28th to the 29th of this month at the State House in Entebbe. These countries, being among the largest economically transformed and among the top exporters in the world, will share some tips with Uganda on how it can grow its economy to boost trade.
Trade is a weapon to end poverty. Otherwise, we shouldn't be doing parish development model. Why are you encouraging people to produce if your eyes are not on the market? Some people have a way they look at this wrongly. They say, no, don't focus on the market. First, be ready. I am a businessman. When I have an opportunity, I will burn the midnight candle to supply that opportunity.
Uganda's exports consist mainly of agricultural products like coffee, fruits and vegetables, flowers and fish products. The country's import earnings are from the energy, construction, agro-processing and tourism sectors. The exports were recorded at $500 million in 2020 compared to imports from the region at $699 million. Report by Jaliet Namwaya for the news.